In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to create a breadcrumb navigator with CSS. We're going to start by creating a UL inside of the body with a class of breadcrumb container. And inside, we're going to create multiple list items with anchor tags. And I'm just going to write home here, so this is going to be the text. And in the hreview, you're going to want to put the path or a link to a file or website that you want to redirect when a user clicks the text. So I'm just going to put a hashtag here. I'm going to copy this and paste it under two times and change the text to section 1 and section 2. And we're going to create another list item, but this one's not going to have an href, and I'm just going to write section 3 in this one. Now we're going to go to our CSS file, select the unordered list with a class of breadcrumb container. Set the list style to none, the background color to this darker white, and the padding to 10 pixels and then 16 pixels. What I'm going to do now is copy this selection, paste it under, and add an li. So I'm going to be selecting the list item instead of the unordered list. And we're going to start by changing the display property to inline, so the list items will be side by side. And change the font size to 16 pixels for now. Under it, we're going to be selecting the list item link. And we're going to start by changing the color to blue and the text decoration to none. And I'm going to change this to something a bit lighter. So something like this should work. What we're going to do now is create the dashes between our list items. So I'm going to copy and paste this under, and I'm going to add a plus sign, another li, and then I'm going to add a before here. I'm going to delete this and set the content to this. Change the color to black and set the padding to 8 pixels. Let's go back now and see what it looks like. So it looks pretty good. You can see that we have to add some hover effects, and the background here is not like in the thumbnail. So you can customize it however you want. I'm going to show you how you can do that. But now let's add some hover effects. So let's copy this right here and paste it under. Add a hover. And all that we're going to do is set the text decoration to underline. And you can add any other styles, so you can change the color if you want. But if we go back now and hover, you can see that now we can see this underline when we hover our links. And now that we're done with the hover effects, let's change the background and make it look a lot better. So I'm going to go to this container, change the display property to inline block, and set the border radius to 10 pixels. And you can obviously set it to whatever you want. But now if we go back, you can see that it looks a lot better. And you can obviously add as many links as you want. And if you haven't realized it yet, this right here, this is not a link. It's just a list item with text. That's because this is going to be the title of the page that you're currently on, so it shouldn't work. And if we actually try to add more links, then you can see that it still looks good. So it's going to look good no matter how many links you have. And I'm going to show you how to change the color of the text here and also the dashes here. So to change the color of the dash, so right here, you can just change the color here to whatever you want. So if you want it to be blue too, or the color that your links are, then you can change it here. And if we go back now, you can see that it works. And if you want to change the text, what you could do is you could just change the color here. So we can set the color to, let's try aqua. If we go back, you can see that now it's going to change to aqua. And also, if you want the text, so this text and also this to be the same color, so the dashes, what you could do is comment this out, and then you can see that now the dashes and your text here is going to be the same color. And this is going to be for this video, so I hope you guys enjoyed it, and leave a like. So for the channel for more content like this, comment down below if you have any video requests, and see you in the next video.